been used over here. So that is why we are getting back, and in this index.html we are first observing which one is the paragraph element over here. So these are the paragraphs, those been used over here. It is inside this position tester class. So stylesheet.css, and here we will be looking for this particular position tester. And here in the first case we will be using this one, this position tester paragraph element. We have created this particular selector, and the behavior of the paragraph element inside this particular selector. Now all we are going to put here, this one is the first letter. We would like to change it over here, so that is why we have provided it. And we can see that this is the font size that we are going to set to 5m. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and you can see that all of these font sizes of the first letter of all these paragraphs, those are practically getting bigger in size. This is due to the fact that we have used this particular pseudo element of first letter into this particular position tester. Now here comes the scenario. We can see that a double colon is been provided automatically. So first letter is practically a completely entirely new element which has been used as the behavior of the paragraph element residing into the position tester selector name. There was nothing like this one, like this first letter or first line if we use letter, or before, after, all these sort of things. Those are practically new elements, those being used over here. There's no span, there's no div element which is residing previously or next to this particular element. So this is an entirely new element which has been used into the document tree, and that is why this is a pseudo element which has been applied to the paragraph element of position tester selector name, which will increase the font size to 5m of the first letter of each and every paragraph element. But now if we get back to our this menu holder, and at the bottom of this particular menu holder UL list A, if we now put here hover, now we can see that this particular hover class, this may be a known element, but this kind of things, this menu holder UL list A, this kind of thing is previously present inside this particular HTML document, and hover is already been recognized as an HTML instruction. So this is not a new element, this is a class which is describing a special behavior of a particular element inside your HTML document. And that is why if we write it down here like this, background color will be changed to what, this one. Get back to your project and reload. Now we will see that there's practically nothing so far, but if we now hover our mouse into our menu items, we can see that the background color is now getting changed. You can see it over here, all those background colors individually on mouse hovering, they are practically getting changed over here. So this is the pseudo class which has been used here, because due to the fact this is not a newer element, this instruction is already been recognized by the HTML document, and it has been applied to an element which is already present into the scenario, which is already been present into the HTML document. But in this particular case where we had made a bigger font size for the first letters of our HTML paragraph elements inside a particular selector name, the element that has been created in this purpose is entirely new element which was not present previously into our HTML document, and that is why they will be referred to as the pseudo element. That's all for today's tutorial. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button down below. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.